Sup, people? This is the Asian Video Gamer. Let me lower the volume a bit. With another live session of Dark Souls 2. Today, we're gonna continue with the Ben Hart series, part 3, and probably the last part. And last time I talked about how the Blue Moon Greatsword has a possibility of being the original Moonlight Greatsword. This video will explore something different other than the sword. So we're not going to talk about the sword anymore. We're going to focus back on Ben Hart as the character in Dark Souls. Well, first off, this guy looks really jacked up with the Scythe of Want and that shield. Yes, gotcha. Jump! I don't use my shield. I don't know what you're doing. Damn. Wow, that lag. It's okay. Not trade. Shit. Got hit by that. That was... Whew! Oh, wow, this guy. Dead. Wow, this guy just pulled out all the stunts, didn't he? Denial and the bow? Wow. Good fight. Good fight. Was not expecting that at all. Good duel. So, what's so special about Ben Hart? He's the only NPC that follows you into the memories of the giants. Captain Gromel, I think that's his name. He's been there as the residence of the memory. Like, the captain actually lives and resides inside the memory. Although he's sort of dying. But you know what I mean. But Ben Hart, he is an actual being that existed outside of the memory and was able to go inside. So this character is kind of a little bit more interesting than other NPCs. Like, he's kind of like the Solaire in Dark Souls. But he's not like weird and, you know, following some... Well, he is trying to... he's obsessed with his sword. But unlike Sunbro, he's able to relinquish this obsession before it gets to him. Possibly the only thing that kept him from being going hollow. But Sunbro, as you know, he kind of becomes sort of... Oh shit. Sort of becomes like... Like a... No, you can't parry that. Sorry for the backstab. Sorry for the poke. Sorry for the lag. And you're dead. Thank you for the duel. It was fun. Maybe I should get some parries off. I haven't gotten a parry off for a long time. So back to what I was saying. So unlike Sunbro, this guy actually was able to not be obsessed with anything and be able to relinquish all his items to you and pass it on to you. And he didn't turn hollow. Well, today we're going to explore the idea of what happens after he helps you with Lissandra. Because you can't summon him for the last fight. And beyond what happens, some speculation. Half of this video is going to be PvP, and then the rest of the half, I have something special in store for you guys. So we're going to just play around with the PvP. Let's talk about focus on the gameplay for now. As you have witnessed in the last two fights, this sword is actually quite good. It's not bad. Oh God, this guy is like decked out. Wow, what is that? I'm dead. Yay, this guy. Yay. Yay for your overpoweredness. Whatever. Yeah, the Sentier Spear. I thought I had that parry on, but guess not. I think I was a tad bit too late for the parry. It's okay. You win some, you lose some, right? The reach of this weapon is not as good as the Claymore, nor is it as good as the Moonlight Greatsword. Okay, what's going on here? What is going on here? I'm stuck in this room. Is it my internet? Is it my internet? Oh God. Yeah, it looks like my internet is pretty shitty today. Let's hope. Oh God, it's one of these guys. Ooh, the parry. Oh God. Oh God! Ran out of stamina there. I thought I had the parry on, but whatever. It's sort of laggy, but my fault. My fault. My fault for losing throughout the. I don't know. I didn't press the roll button in time to escape that first combo, which took me to nothing. Completely my fault. Oh, this guy again. Shit, the guy with the Santir spear. So this time, not gonna be fancy. He didn't bow last time. Let's see what he does. Yeah, he's not bowing again. What the hell? Wow, I didn't get that parry on. Really? Oh well, whatever. Did not get that parry off, even though I knew it was coming. I need to press that really faster. Spear is really annoying because it's a thrust attack. The hitbox is crazy. And maybe on my screen, I see it as crazy. Maybe on his screen, it's actually reasonable. I don't know. Fighting games and lag has always been an issue. Like if you play Street Fighter and all that type of games, like, you know, like, lag is always a problem. So this guy looks like he has a straight, a katana, sorry. I was gonna say straight sword. Oh God. Wow, that hitbox. That didn't hit him. Okay, where is he going? I'm right behind you. EA. So far, this guy's perfect. And I will not die without hitting you. Yes! I hit you. And then that fucking, I don't know. He swing the other way and hits me. Whatever. Maybe my connection's really bad today. Usually it's not like that. So, four losses in a row after such a good start. Yo, what's going on, guys? Two more, and then I'll move on to the story part of this video. So, something to talk about Ben Hart. The guy is, at first, you see he seems like somewhat of a, you know, the brawler type, and he's able to, and he's sort of dumb, because he gets stuck because there's a statue there. He's not able to move on. None of these NPCs are able to move on until they talk to you. Well, I mean, like, it's a game aspect, but come on, like, you should be able to move on even if you can't. Oh, there's this guy again, the Kung Fu master guy. Wow, he seems to have unlimited stamina to be able to throw that type of shit. I've seen you before. Yo, what the fuck? No, bitch. Get out of here. Oh, God. No. Wow, that didn't hit. Lag, 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 lag. Your punch not gonna hit me again. I knew what you were gonna do. When you know what happens and you try to avoid it, it's not that hard of a game. He was trying to prove himself to use punches and shit to win, but it's not that hard to beat somebody when you know what they're all about. And that's why I like the simple builds, like the build with a sword and a shield. You can do a lot of variety of moves without being too predictable. And at the same time, you can be pretty overpowered. I think this guy just pulled out like a silver towel. No, this is the first guy we played. Yeah, this is the first guy with the denial. So this guy has a denial on. I think last time I got a backstab off. Oh God, I got no stamina. Okay, recuperate. Ah! Oh shit, He fell. Didn't expect that. Wow, he jumped right in front of me. That was weird. Oh god. Yeah, he beat me. Good fight. The Skive is actually really hard to use, so give him props for trying to use it. I mean, sure, he has like other backup stuff like the bow, the denial, and all that junk. Oh, I said two more, right? Shit. Okay, this is gonna be last fight. I did not break 500 today. Whatever. I mean, 50%. It's fine. It's okay. Whatever. It's not a big deal. But, you know, as I was saying, like, the simple sword and shield combo is actually very versatile against a lot of things. Like, if you need to parry, you have to parry. If you need, like, standard swings, you have the swings. If you need the thrust, well, you can do the rolling thrust. Usually, the rolling thrust is not as good as, like, a thrust sword, but I'd rather use this. Oh, Schwarzenegger. I'd rather use the rolling thrust because it does, like, throw people off guard and you can hit people that way and possibly combo one more hit. Oh, this guy wants a gesture. Let him. I'll give him one too. So, the thing on the bridge is just don't panic roll. Okay. Okay. Was that? Okay. Okay, this is so laggy. And I died. Just said I was not gonna panic roll and then that happens. Interesting lag, because I'm stuck on the screen now. So I guess it's not a very good day to play. It's okay. So let's go on to the story aspect of the game. In order to do that, we got to travel to here. The final resting place where Benhard is. So after giving you the sword, after killing the three bosses, I guess either Throne Watch. I don't think Throne Watcher counts. I think you have to kill the Sandra before it counts as the third boss. So, okay, these guys don't even hurt. They're just annoying. Die. I don't think it counts if you summon him for the Throne Watcher fight. So you have to either kill the Giant Lord or Nissandra. I mean, you can always Bonfire Acidic and then do it again to make it count, but that's cheap. So I'm gonna just say, like, you have to fight either the Giant Lord or Lissandra. So after, like, near the end of the story, this is after the story, like, after near the ending of the game, he goes into this place. So he is close to the end of his journey, and this is the place where he gives you his stuff, the memory of Oro. See, one cannot reside within memory for long. But he's able to stay here for indefinite time. It's kind of awkward. That alone makes me feel like this guy is from Mira. And he says he knows how swords think. So In parallel, the Blue Moon Greatsword is like Benhard. He's not a real swordsman. All his clothing was found off the street. He dressed up like a real hero. Look at his stuff. But he himself is not very special, other than having brute strength. So this character parallels Solaire a lot. But unlike Solaire, he was not obsessed with the sun, with whatever. He just wanted to prove that he was strong enough to unlock the power in this Blue Moon Greatsword. But unfortunately, this Blue Moon Greatsword has no inner powers. And at the end of it, after vanquishing all the enemies in here, all the monsters in here, after even killing the Nissandra of Want, he was not able to unlock this power. Hence, he gave you the sword. And he gave you his armor. And he sits here in the memory until you come back and you face him one last time. Goodbye, my friend. This is the end of the rope for you. Bye. I said bye. 500. So let's see how much hit point he actually has. Where's your shield? Come on, grab your shield out, or you're gonna die. I'll treat you like a human. Oh God. Come on. Oh God. That was a bad mistake. Unfortunately, he's not very hard to kill. That was to show you the real sword, right, guys? I have mastered your sword, Benhard. Come. And here's the final touch. What is done is done. And what do you get when you kill him? You get his Blue Moon Great Sword. His second pair. Unfortunately, this character cannot wield it because of the stats. You need to be like 40 strength and I don't know. Guts ahead, impossible, therefore sorcery. So after all his travels, he's no longer needed, and he even has a second pair after you kill him. Therefore, perhaps the Blue Moon Greatsword is fake. No one knows how FromSoft creates these lines of stories, and no one will ever know the true meaning of anything, of any of this. Whether this sword is real, that sword was not, nobody will ever know, or I'm just in denial myself. Well, I hope you guys enjoy the videos, enjoy watching me get my ass kicked. and hopefully you also enjoyed me slaughtering Ben Hart and taking his other sword. So one last PvP with a real Moonlight Greatsword, and hopefully that will be it for this series. So if you enjoyed live commentary and live storytelling type stuff, or me just rambling garbage, please leave a comment, subscribe to the channel for more, and hopefully I can get a duel going earlier. If not, I'll just go to the Iron Keep and just fight. There's a whole bunch just before. Why is there nobody now? Why is it taking so long now? Weird. Weird Dark Soul matchmaking. I mean, don't get me wrong, the Dark Souls PvP matchmaking is actually very, very good. It's much better than Street Fighter, I'll tell you that. But it does have its problems. Lag is always an issue in fighting games. This is not really a fighting game, more or less a RPG PvP type game. But, you know, I consider this with fighting. You know, you can't just spam R1 and hope to win. Even though you see that I do that all the time. Oh, there's go. There you go. There you go. So, one last duel. With Ben Hart achieving being able to grab the real Moonlight Greatsword. So instead of this, let's wear this. Oh, it doesn't work. There you go. Yes, no fat rolls. And it's with some guy with a sword that's glowing. And this guy's wearing a Minotaur hat. Head. Oh, that's pretty annoying. That's pretty awesome. I'm sorry. I said annoying. Well, his sword is annoying. Ah, couldn't bait that. Wow, this sword deals no damage. Two hits for 500? Are you serious? And I forgot I don't have. Yay, he hit me. I gotta jump back. I'm gonna do a parry. No! Yeah, he's not like the type to jump and he's dead. Dope! Yeah, baby! So, see you guys next time. Toodles.